Hey there, sis. It's me again. Hey, I just wanted to, in this episode, I wanted to talk a little bit more about editing in iPhoto, just so you can kind of see how to do some retouching or cropping, things like that, and go into that in a little bit more detail. So hope you find this one useful. So hey there, sis. We're in iPhoto now, and we're going to talk about editing pictures. And so you'll see in the left-hand corner here, I'm in the editing menu, and there's a couple tabs at the top, or three tabs at the top. There's quick fixes, there's effects, and there's adjust. We're going to focus on quick fixes right now, and we'll go through these various items and show you how to edit a picture, and then the other episodes we'll talk about the other tools. And I know what you're thinking. There's this picture here of me, and you're thinking, how can we edit a picture of Andy to make it look better because he looks awesome? But I'll show you the tools and how they work. So the first tool we have is rotate, and it does what it says. Basically, you just click on the button, and it rotates it in a counterclockwise direction. And so I can just keep rotating until I get to the direction I want. So if you happen to have a picture that's off by 90 degrees, you just hit that rotate button to get it oriented the way you want. The next button we have is enhance. And it's an auto enhance button. So what it does, you'll see it made the picture a little bit brighter. So it kind of basically just analyzes the picture and enhances it based on an algorithm that it has within the program. And the next button here is fix red eye. I don't have any red eye to fix, but if there was a picture with red eye, just click the red eye button and it would just fix the red eye automatically. So if you have somebody like we have Tyler, who no matter what picture we take of him, it seems like there's always red eye. And so you can easily fix that. And then there's the straighten tool. If I click on that, it's gonna let me basically adjust the picture. So I can use the slider. So if I was just off a little bit and wasn't quite right, I could straighten it out using that tool. Then I'll just hit done. And then crop is exactly what it says. It will actually crop the picture, let you crop the picture, and you just kind of drag these handles to crop it. But if you want to constrain the proportions and keep it the same, you can do that as well. But what I'll do here is I'll just drag this corner, and then I can actually move this around and center everything, and then I can say done, and now it is cropped. So it's pretty straightforward. The nice thing is if you have a picture where you've got a lot of background or something, and you want to zero in on a particular thing, or you kind of want to, make it look a little more artsy fartsy, you can do that with the crop. You can kind of crop out what you don't need, and get what you do need. So, and then there's the retouch tool. And so you can like if you have the blemish on the picture or some kind of spot on the picture, you can kind of fix that with the retouch tool. You can here with the slider bar, you can determine the size of the tool. I'll leave that as default, but you can see here it gives me a circle, and I could kind of remove like that picture if I wanted to, or kind of fix it if I wanted to. So just kind of does some auto retouching for you. And then I'll hit done here. And the nice thing is, like I mentioned before, any edit you do, it's non-destructive. So I can always hit this revert to original, and boom, it's back to the original image. So that is the quick fixes editing menu.